Wait, was he waving? We're good? Okay.
Sí.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for attending this Aspen Ideas Festival session about the global influence of Cuban music. This is a great topic, but of course, since it involves music, it's always best to start music and talking about music by listening to music. It is a topic that can be understood, but first it has to be felt. So, this gentleman to my left is Orlando Maraca Valle, an incredible musician who, from Havana, his compatriot in crime, wife, talented manager, also flute player, also from Paris, France originally. Now they live in Havana. They tour all over the world. Maraca first came to perform at the Jazz Aspen Stumass Festival in 1999. And they were here for 5 days, set the town on fire. We're very happy that now with the change in the ability of Cuban musicians to come into the United States, that they're back doing a one-month tour, which is really exciting. And before we start talking about some of the questions that I have for Maraca, we're gonna let the band play something very typical, and then we're gonna talk about the music, and there will be music throughout this session as we allow them to demonstrate some of the different facets of this incredible music. So first, please move us, and then we will talk.
Good morning. Good morning.
No translation needed.
It's all improvised, so for you.
And they'll keep it short, yeah, just a few, 5 minutes.
Cortico. Tell.
Maraca.
Cortico.
Andy Ruala, piano. José Miguel, al timbal. Aquí tenemos Rafael Valiente, las congas, y on the bass, Yosmel Montejo.
Okay, so here's the first question that I wanted to ask Maraca. How has Cuban music, despite the isolation it has experienced in the last 50 years, managed to have access to so much music from around the world? How did the music get in? Or was this largely the result of Cuban musicians who traveled outside Cuba and brought music back with them?
Primeramente, seamos sinceros. Seamos sinceros.
Oh, let's be honest and frank.
Yes. Con esa magnífica pregunta que Jim ha formulado, queda demostrado que el embargo o bloqueo no sirvió para nada.
Well, all it demonstrates that the embargo during 50 years on Cuba didn't work.
Y lo digo desde el punto de vista artístico, musical,
from
no
a
político.
Cultural point of view, at least, uh-huh. It didn't work that much.
O sea, es una cosa muy evidente que 50 años después, una cultura que se trató de cerrar, una comunicación, aumentó, o sea, mejoró.
Oh, in spite of the intended tentative of isolate Cuba, mm-hmm. Music and musicians could still receive music from all over the world.
Y es cierto que bueno, los músicos cubanos hemos traído, o sea, hemos importado al país muchas grabaciones, experiencias, videos.
And it's also true that Cuban musicians are very demanded all over the world, mm-hmm. So they play in many countries. Mm-hmm.
Pero por otro lado, se nos ha impedido en general, ¿no? Venir y tocar nuestra música, nuestro arte aquí en Estados Unidos.
But in the case of the US, it was difficult for the Cuban musician come and play here during many years.
Nosotros somos afortunados de ser amigos musicales de este señor Jim Horowitz.
We're very lucky to be your musical friend and to have been able to be in Aspen several times.
Es uno una de las personas que más ha contribuido a la expansión de nuestra cultura, de nuestra música aquí en
and
Estados Unidos.
And promoters like you are very important in this, you know, exchange.
Así que debemos agradecer a él, a este festival y a ustedes mismos que están
and we thank you for your support and for your
escuchando
interest.
Lo que hablamos y lo que estamos tocando.
With pleasure. So let's talk about Afro-Cuban music. Afro-Cuban music is a broad description that is something that describes music which has happened in Cuba, very much created by Cuban musicians. This is a fascinating thing to understand, and we'd like Maraca to explain to us a little bit about this thing which is called Afro-Cuban music and how did it happen.
Bueno, mira. La música afrocubana es el reflejo de la realidad que ha habido históricamente en Cuba.
The African music is the reflect of the history of the cultural heritage in Cuba.
Es un poco la evolución de la cultura, por ejemplo, dominante que había, que era la española.
It's the evolution of the Spanish culture mixed with the
la cultura prohibida e importada a la misma vez, que era la africana.
With the African prohibited culture. By that time.
Y otras que también llegaron, o sea, la cultura inglesa, la cultura francesa,
and other americana. Culture who was also in Cuba, French culture.
Y entonces se formó como si fuera un burrito.
And it came all together and it's like a burrito.
Como guacamole, huevo, frijoles.
Very mixed influences.
O sea, para que entiendan, ¿no? Lo que es la música cubana. Entonces, los esclavos africanos tenían prohibido su cultura, su religión, todo.
So African people, of course, came to Cuba as slaves, mm-hmm. and it was forbidden for them, you know, to express their culture.
Pero increíblemente se mantuvo.
But they kept it secret.
Hasta tal punto que se fundió con las demás culturas, fundamentalmente la española.
And it was so strong that it penetrated the Spanish one in Cuba.
Y la misma, la propia cultura española ya venía mezclada con cosas de África del Norte. De
and even Spanish culture was already mixed with North African culture from Morocco.
Y en la música, por supuesto, eso trajo la danza, la contradanza, que, o sea, son periodos y evoluciones de la música que llegó a Cuba y creció, se convirtió en música cubana.
And other genders such as danza and contradanza are coming from the French and the more European culture and was also mixed.
Eso fue evolucionando hasta el danzón, el mambo, el cha-cha-cha, todas esas cosas.
And it became the danzón, the cha-cha-cha, the mambo, uh-huh. all these influences together.
Y por el matiz afro, le llaman, o sea, porque es música cubana, pero es afro-cubana, porque es música que tiene mucha fuerza africana.
And afro-cuban is a term because it's a lot of African elements in Cuban music.
Pero ya no es música española, ya no es música francesa y ya no es música africana, es música afro-cubana.
So that's why Cuban music is defined not like European music nor African music, but Afro-Cuban music.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Let's talk a little bit about jazz and its influence on Cuban music and tell us how did jazz music become such an important part of the music that he's playing and that has been created by musicians like Maraca in Cuba.
Bueno, el jazz y la música afro-cubana tienen puntos muy en común, o sea, casi que surgieron al mismo tiempo.
Jazz and Cuban music have some common points.
Y son dos procesos parecidos, pero no iguales.
And they experience the same process, not exactly the same, but similar process.
Desde el punto de vista africano, bueno, comenzó como una protesta ante los colonos, por la explotación a que eran salvajes, a que eran sometidos.
Both African people came to the U.S. and to Cuba as slaves. They were prohibited. I mean, their culture was prohibited.
Después, eso finalmente fue aceptado por los propios colonos porque necesitaban diversión y la gente, los ritmos afrocubanos eran muy fuertes y les gustaban.
But then it became pretty much accepted. You know, integrated in the music, in jazz, in both.
Y entonces empezaron las historias de amor, los romanticismos entre los colonos y los africanos.
And they also kind of mixed together, the white people and in Cuba, the white and the black.
Y se empezaron a mezclar la raza, la cultura, los gustos.
So that's why in Cuba there are many race mixing.
Pero hay muchas cosas en común, o sea, la forma de improvisar.
So the common element is the improvisation, for example.
El desarrollo armónico en Estados Unidos fue increíble, es increíble.
In the jazz in the US, the harmonic element is predominant.
Y el desarrollo rítmico en Cuba también es increíble.
Meanwhile, in Cuba, the rhythmic element was the strongest.
Entonces uno complementa al otro y finalmente se fueron encontrando.
So they're quite complementary, and one can be easily completed by the elements of the other.
Hay
That's why it mixed so well.
Muy antigua de los primeros cubanos que irrumpieron en la música de jazz o la música americana. Pero, por ejemplo, un ejemplo, en mi caso, que soy flautista, Alberto Socarrás fue el primer flautista que grabó un disco de jazz en la historia y era cubano.
And, for example, the first flute player in Cuba who ever recorded a jazz record was at the beginning of the century.
Y debemos mencionar a grandes cultores
Socarrás.
De la música de jazz y de la música cubana como fueron Machito.
And many Cuban musicians used to go to the US and perform there, like Machito, who became very influential
Mario
in
Bausa,
jazz, Mario Bosa,
Chano Pozo,
all of them were Cuban musicians
in
the US.
And these were musicians that were coming to the US before 1950,
eso fue
correct?
Mucho antes.
Yes,
o sea, de los años 30. El flautista que hablé fue en el año 1928.
The first Cuban flute player who recorded jazz in Cuba was 1929.
En el mundo, el primer disco de jazz, el primer flautista de jazz que grabó fue cubano.
29, 29 28. 28. 28.
Después en los años 30, bueno, estaba ya Mario Bauzá, después vino Machito.
Then in the late 30s, Mario Bauzá, Machito.
Muchos más, Chico Farrell.
Chico Farrell.
Pero Dizzy Gillespie, que es totalmente, o era, americano, hizo una obra llamada Manteca con Chano Pozo, que es considerada prácticamente el nacimiento o la fusión del jazz con la música cubana.
So Cuban musicians and US musicians used to perform a lot together before the revolution. Mm. And even US musicians like Dizzy Gillespie created songs and full style with Cuban musicians, for example, like in Manteca,
a very famous jazz song. Me gustaría mucho compartirlo con ustedes, que lo pudieran escuchar en una.
I would like you to listen to a small extract of Manteca, for example.
Yes, let's do that. So, this is the song by Dizzy Gillespie called Manteca, a very famous song in the canon of this kind of music. And this was written in the 1940s, yes? So, recording the, like one of the originals from the 40s? Or?
Giovanni Hidalgo.
So, Dizzy Gillespie, a great American jazz trumpet player who was one of the most influential jazz musicians to bring Latin Cuban music into the American jazz canon, if you will, that developed that. There's a very strong African connection for the culture, which is called Yoruba. And this is a very important thing to understand about Afro-Cuban music and about really this music that happened, and I would like Maraca to explain a little bit about what Yoruba culture from Africa is and how it helped to influence this music.
Bueno, una anécdota de la conexión entre, o sea, Yoruba, ¿no? Entre África y Cuba. es cuando estuvimos tocando con este grupo en Costa de Marfil.
There's a funny story about the Yoruba connection in Cuban music when we performed once in Ivory Coast in Africa.
Empezamos a tocar el concierto como siempre, ¿no? Y para sorpresa nuestra, lo que cantábamos lo respondía el público.
And we started to play a kind of Yoruba song, the singer's song in Yoruba, you know, not in Spanish. And people from the audience would respond to the band.
Y por supuesto, bueno, después estuvimos conversando con las personas ahí locales sobre ese idioma Yoruba.
We had the opportunity after the show, you know, to have some talks and conversation with some of the African people who attended the show.
Ese idioma existe actualmente en esa región de África.
So the Yoruba language still, of course, does exist in Africa nowadays.
Pero ellos nos explicaron que el Yoruba antiguo, o sea, el tradicional que llegó a Cuba, ellos lo perdieron.
But they explained to us that the ancient Yoruba got lost in Africa. So that was like their grandfather's language that the Cuban was still speaking.
Nosotros lo conservamos tal como llegó a Cuba.
And in Cuba, they kept it like it came in Cuba two centuries ago.
Entonces, esa es la diferencia ahora que hay entre África y Cuba, ¿no? Que
so
están reencontrándose.
So this is the difference between, you know, the Yoruba language in Africa, who kept evolving, mm-hmm. and the Yoruba language in Cuba, which they like two centuries ago. Mm-hmm.
Pero también existen otras culturas, o sea, entre otras. Había en Cuba Bantú, Arará, o sea, no es solamente Yoruba.
But in Cuban music, slaves came from everywhere from Africa. So many other cultures, not only the Yoruba one, are represented in Cuba and were mixed with music.
Uh-huh. Y también en la parte de la religión, que está muy mezclada con eso, influyó también, bueno, la santería. El propio vudú haitiano de alguna manera entró en Cuba. Hay influencias también muy potentes de la cultura jamaicana.
So through the music, of course, religion was very was very important in their culture, in African culture. So all the music coming from Yoruba culture and the other tribes of Africa were religious purposes.
Pero seamos claros, ¿no? Estamos en el 2011, ya no estamos en aquella época.
Okay.
Y entonces ya estamos más evolucionados. Nosotros mismos hemos hecho fusiones con música yoruba y otras músicas, o sea, culturas de origen africano, pero con fusiones con jazz, con música cubana actual.
So what we do usually is we pick up some Yoruba music elements and we mix it with other, you know, elements.
So
and other stuff.
Last night when you performed, and the very beginning of the show, if I don't know if anyone, I know one, so some people who were there, I don't know if anybody had the pleasure to hear the full. Maraca is here with a 15-piece band. We are here with the choir. But at the beginning, was this a Yoruba kind of a singing chant that happened in the beginning of this?
Yes, it was like a prayer.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. También
religious.
Se me olvidó decir que también eso está presente en los instrumentos, como el batá, los tambores batá.
And along with the language, Yoruba,
Bantu,
and of, you know, these different tribes, along with that came the instruments. Mm-hmm. So they brought with them the drums, mm-hmm. you know, the African drums.
Y entonces, por ejemplo, yo provengo de
batá.
El chequeré,
batá, yes.
Yo provengo de un barrio, o sea, ¿cómo le llaman? Un town, un barrio. Donde había mucha rumba, mucha santería, mucha. Estamos casi en África. Estamos en La Habana, pero estamos casi en África.
And Maraca was born in a district where religion and African religion was very important and dominant. Mm.
Y entonces estoy acostumbrado a esos sonidos.
So it's very used to this sound and the ceremony and the ritual.
Que son ambientes, son como pinturas, imágenes, ¿no?
And it's very important for him when he creates music and compose.
Y son músicas que llevan décadas los musicólogos y los especialistas tratando de clasificar, tratando de escribir, pero no lo logran. O sea, esa es una música que no pertenece al pentagrama, pertenece al corazón africano, que es intuitivo, es como una ciencia, es como una realidad que se vive.
And this music is very intuitive. It's not so written, but it's intuitive.
Y también en géneros como la rumba. se hace igual, o sea, hay coros, hay historias que se narran, hay una persona que improvisa, hay otras personas que bailan, hay elementos teatrales, no solamente
musicales. And it's a very structural music and ritual where...
Does he have something in there to demonstrate of this? Yes.
¿Tú podrías enseñar algo?
So.
Sí, lo que pasa es que el Big Bang está viajando.
No, de la música.
Or together with, as he wants.
Oh, con la música quizás.
Yes, if... As if he can do it with, if he can do it with them.
Una aproximación porque faltan cantantes, faltan alguna gente.
Yes, well, we will try with a reduced format.
También aclaro que me sacaron de la cama, entonces no he podido ni calentar.
Usually, rumba ensemble are big with a lot of drums.
Esto, por ejemplo, tiene un rezo que lo hace un cantante.
This is a kind of prayer. Pray.
Y entonces ahora vamos a hacer el coro y la fusión.
It's like
Coco, a Colona, a Colona, ven. Y dice.
This is the jazz version of the Yoruba chant, which you first heard. Now the musicians improvise over this basic musical form that you heard. And at the very beginning of that, what you heard with maraca starting and then the musicians answering is something which is a very African tradition, which also slipped into American music. It's called call and response. And this is a very, very ancient form of music which was seen in American music and gospel music. It came into all early Black American music, and you see these African roots of this are exactly. This is where it really came from, originally, from this kind of culture in Africa. And as they said, when they performed in Côte d'Ivoire and they started to make this, all of a sudden, they were playing, and then the people in the audience sang back to them. That was the natural way that they did it. So that was great. So what we'd like to do now a little bit is to help talk about the basic rhythm, the rhythmic structure, as Celine mentioned, between jazz and Cuban music. Jazz more emphasizing the harmonic side, Cuban music emphasizing the rhythmic side, and this beautiful blend is what made all of this music, a lot of which you will recognize many of these rhythms, but now these musicians are going to help us understand the building blocks of Cuban music, and these include clave, rumba, son, and salsa. So please explain to us how it starts.
Quería explicar un poquito, ¿no? Para que entiendan de dónde sale la columna vertebral de la música cubana o afro-cubana es la clave.
Yes, the main pattern in Cuban music is named clave.
La estaban haciendo ahorita espontáneamente. Es ta, 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 ta. Si me acompañan, por favor, vamos a ir añadiendo elementos a la clave para que entiendan la complejidad de nuestra música, ¿no? Entonces yo le pido por favor
que let's try the clave all together and see what's going on. ¿Saben qué pasa?
A eso podemos añadirle la conga.
Then the conga patterns come in the top of this. Now the bass pattern would come like this. Getting lost.
It's hard for me.
The maracas. The guiro. But he lost the stick, but it doesn't matter. He will play the guiro with the maracas. Then we have the bell. When the singer starts to improvise, the bell comes on. Then the answer to the bell is the counter bell on the timbales. Call and response. Huh? Call and response all the time. Yes, yes. But what you can't miss is the clave, so you have to really to keep on doing the clave all the time. Come on. Thank you. So you can see how every instrument answers to the other.
Por supuesto, si vamos a enseñar cada uno de los elementos, estaríamos durante todo el festival más los otros festivales que vienen.
Of course, there are many, many other ways.
Posiblemente pudiéramos hacer patterns antes de terminar.
And we will probably go until winter, and you know, to explaining different patterns in Cuban music.
Pero bueno, espero que hayan sentido una emoción y que hayan entendido un poquito más.
But we hope you can feel that everything is linked together and the importance of the dynamic of every instrument and that you liked it.
Y esos son elementos que llegaron de África, se fundieron con otros españoles, franceses, como expliqué anteriormente, y devinieron en esto, que es la música cubana.
So the percussion, of course, came from Africa, and the piano and the bass were mostly European elements, influences.
Excellent. Okay, so how about the rumba? Tell us about the rumba.
Háblanos la rumba.
La rumba, según, hay un vínculo, o sea, según los libros, o sea, no lo inventé yo. La rumba surge como una manifestación teatral.
Rumba was like a theatrical manifestation.
Tenía música, por supuesto, una música más, un poco más moderna, más urbana.
It was mainly urban music.
O sea, la rumba nuestra, o sea, la rumba.
The Cuban Cuba. Rumba.
Y es un complejo musical, o sea, tiene varios, el mismo género tiene varias facetas, o sea.
There are many styles, different styles in rumba.
El guaguancó.
One called guaguancó.
El yambú.
Yambú.
La columbia.
All of these are different styles.
Y la jiribilla.
In rumba.
Cada uno, unos son más lentos, unos más rápidos.
Some of them are slow, some of them are faster.
Tienen algunas características diferentes.
And they have their old characteristic.
La clave que ahora mismo tocamos pa 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 cambia y es pa 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 pa.
For example, the clave you played, sorry, it's not the same than in rumba. The clave of rumba is very different.
Es un ritmo muy complejo.
And the rhythm are very complex.
Pero una vez, o sea, a nivel de anécdota, ¿no? Una vez estábamos tocando a un pueblo muy muy remoto en Irlanda.
Well, I remember one time we played in a very far small village in Ireland.
Ireland?
Era un club que estaba dentro de un hotel parecido a donde tocamos anoche.
It was a club in a hotel, but in the middle of the countryside of nowhere.
Y en el soundcheck, o sea, había una prueba de sonido, estábamos tocando una rumba.
And during the soundcheck, the band started to play a rumba.
Que no estaba incluido en el concierto ni en el repertorio, o sea, lo tocamos
just
porque
queríamos. Just for fun, tocar. You know, it was not included in the repertoire. They started to
y
improvise
en un momento,
on drums.
Yo me alejé, salí a una puerta.
And then Maraca went to a door.
Por supuesto, fuera habían vacas y hierbas.
And what he could see was cows and grass.
Pero me quedé impresionado por las vacas. Vinieron rápidamente. Yo estaba tocando una campana.
And he was playing the cowbell and all the cows came down.
Y yo pensé que iba a ser agredido por las vacas. Y lo que pasa es que les gustaba el ritmo.
They seemed to enjoy the cowbell very much.
Y entonces descubrimos así.
They stopped eating.
Descubrimos así que la rumba le gusta a la vaca también. O sea, no
so we discovered that cows can be fond of rumba too.
Y realmente, eso fue verdad, no mentira. Realmente la rumba es un ritmo que arrollador, no sé cómo se dice en inglés.
That's it. Rumba is a very infectious rhythm. Mm-hmm. You know.
Es increíble. Y hay vínculos también en el ritmo de la rumba y lo que denominan conga o comparsa.
So it often ends in carnival stuff. You know, very
son,
festive rhythm.
Son música que se tocan en fiestas grandes donde hay muchas personas.
Rumba are played where parties are.
Narran historias
cotidianas,
¿no?
Daily stories.
Y en principio, por supuesto, como mismo hemos hecho toda la historia de la música afrocubana, empezaron a protestar por el maltrato y la esclavitud, pero bueno, ya eso quedó atrás. Ahora estamos en etapas sociales, crónicas sociales son lo que se narran ahora.
Mm-hmm. Social stories are told through rumba. You know,
ejemplo,
sad stories and happy stories.
No sé, o sea, una rumba lleva muchos elementos, muchos instrumentos de percusión.
And rumba include many, many different percussion instruments.
Esa especificidad la vamos a dejar para la próxima conferencia y concierto que hagamos aquí en Aspen.
Next show in Aspen, we will show you some rumba stuff.
All right.
Podemos insistir más en la rumba, pero ahora lo que podemos hacer es un poquito con estos músicos maravillosos que tenemos aquí.
And we're going to play a little rumba.
Con Valiente, para los cuales pido un aplauso.
Rafael Valiente on congas is going to play some rumba.
Y otros rumberos pasivos que tenemos aquí atrás.
And passive rumba
pero
players
van a hacer sus cosas también. Y
on
bueno,
the piano and the bass.
Van a ver que el corazón le va a hacer boom, boom, boom. Siempre.
With the heart.
Benlem, 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 balamba, wiro. La rumba, pero la rumba suena bien. Alam, benlem, 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 ba. Oye, la rumba suena bien, porque la rumba con ganas se baila bien sabrosa porque es música cubana. A los rumberos se les canta con amor y la rumba suena buena porque lleva corazón. Baila, baila con mi rumba. ¿Qué dice el coro? ¿Qué dice el coro? Baila, baila con mi rumba. Baila que mi rumba tiene brillumba. Mi rumba tiene sabor. Baila.
Baila con mi rumba.
Como dice el coro, baila con mi rumba.
Baila, baila con mi rumba.
Oye, pero qué bonito como suena el tumbador. Baila, baila con mi rumba. Mi rumba tiene mendó, mi rumba tiene brillumba. Baila, baila con mi rumba. A la metangala.
Baila con mi rumba.
Sí. A la metangala, a la meta buena. La rumba tiene swing porque está en primera. Y dice, baila, baila con mi rumba. Pero baila, conga. Baila, baila con mi rumba. Suena el timba maraca. Baila, baila con mi rumba. 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 Hey.
Whoa.
It's almost always
yes.
Dancing.
Yeah, as Salim was saying, almost always dancing is involved in rumba. Now you know why. And by the way, you just saw something happen that is so typical of Cuban music. These guys can play everything. They move around, and if you ever have the chance to go to Cuba, and I don't know if any of you have, but when you go there, you will find music oozing from the pores of this country everywhere, every street corner. The amount of music and the quality is something staggering to behold. And when you watch people who move amongst instruments, this is very, very, very unusual. We see a lot of great musicians here in Aspen and at our festival and the music festival. It's very unusual to see someone who can move from one instrument to the other equally well. This is the quality of the music in Cuba. So we want to talk about another kind of music related to Cuban music, part of it, which is called son, S-O-N. And son relates to, and we can talk about that in Buena Vista and the traditional folkloric Cuban music. And then we're going to move to the more modern form, but let's talk a little bit about son and what this is.
Bueno, el son es lo que tocamos al principio.
Son was mostly what we played at the beginning.
Remember the clave, ta, ta, ta.
Oh, this clave ta, you ta. Played was the son clave. Actually.
Con las maracas que tocamos, que
with
es el estilo
maracas,
de son.
The maracas, the tumbao on the piano.
Pero viene más de campo, de montaña.
And the son, not like the rumba, is mostly country music. It's like, it's country music.
Folkloric music.
Sí, pero, o sea, hay que separar, o sea, no se puede separar, pero es diferente a lo que hemos hablado de Yoruba, de
Very
Bantú.
Different from the urban
más,
music
más
and
fundido,
rumba.
Más fundido, yo pienso más mitad, 50-50, español.
Yeah, half Spanish heritage,
salió
half,
de la parte,
you know,
más
African.
Oriental de Cuba.
And it was born on the eastern part of the island, Santiago de Cuba.
Aquí tenemos un santiaguero, por ejemplo.
Our pianist is from Santiago de Cuba, for example.
Y entonces, nada, el son es un género que sirvió también para desarrollar otro. Después se le puso una etiqueta, después del año 59. Que pasó la ruptura política entre Cuba y Estados Unidos, muchos artistas de Cuba viajaron a Estados Unidos o a otras partes del mundo, se fueron de Cuba.
So sound was a gender which was very useful as a base for other genders in Cuba. From the sound was born other rhythm. And when the Cuban Revolution came happened in 59, Cuban musicians stopped to travel to the U.S.
Y entonces se empezó a mezclar, entraron elementos de Venezuela, de Colombia, de Puerto Rico, de otros países, ¿no? Latinoamericanos.
Antes de 59.
Antes había, pero se agrupó en una etiqueta que le pusieron comercial salsa, que no existía como género.
Then the song which was known in the U.S. They started to call it salsa, you know, and started to put a commercial name on it, which was a kind of other son Montuno, but mixed with other influences from Puerto Rico, from Venezuela.
Es un son más moderno,
most modern,
con elementos también de ritmos que son no cubanos, o sea, son puertorriqueños,
with
con la plena.
Puerto Rican rhythm.
La cumbia que
and it became salsa in the U.S. Meanwhile, in Cuba, it kept on being son, the traditional son.
Y entonces ya le empezaron a llamar a todo salsa.
But then, with the heavy marketing of the, you know, U.S. Cuban U.S. musician, salsa was the generic term to design to designate all of song and Pero other Cuban
style. This whole kind of music was lumped together in America. That's called salsa.
Yeah, that's what everybody knows as salsa.
Yo poseo mucha información y documentos auditivos que no los voy a poner ahora porque los voy a cansar con tanta cosa, pero que demuestran que ya existían géneros como el danzón, el cha-cha-cha, la rumba, el mambo en Cuba antes de la etiqueta salsa.
But before it was called salsa, many genders existed in Cuba and kept on existing, you know, and they would never call them salsa in Cuba.
Right. Only in Cuba, son. In America, salsa.
Sí, no, hasta en Cuba le llaman salsa, pero bueno, lo
importante. Now they call it salsa in Cuba because it's easier.
Lo importante que la salsa tuvo el nivel de publicidad de comercio que nosotros
tenemos. Obviously, the salsa was getting much more promotion and marketing all over the world. Meanwhile, the son in Cuba, you know, because of the embargo, did that way.
Paradójicamente,
there was no promotion at all.
Paradójicamente, muchos años después que se inventara la etiqueta salsa, productores americanos e ingleses llegaron a Cuba y volvieron a publicar internacionalmente lo que nunca dejamos de hacer en Cuba, que era el son y la rumba y otros géneros.
And then famous producer, US producer and English producer came to Cuba and rediscovered the son.
Eso fue muy importante porque el Buenavista Social Club.
And those men were the producer of Buena Vista Social Club, so they rediscovered the song and put it, you know, promoted all over the world. So the world rediscovered that song existed, but in Cuba it never disappeared, you know, it was always there.
Redescubrió y motivó un interés por Cuba y por la
música. But thanks to Buena Vista Social Club, people were aware of the traditional song of Cuba, you know, and liked it very
much. Y bueno,
nos
permitió a nosotros reconocer internacionalmente a personalidades que no tenían ese reconocimiento. Injustamente, como Omar Aportuondo, Cachaito y todos los
Musicians like Omar Aportuondo and Ibrahim Ferrer, you know, musicians from Buena Vista Social Club became very famous all over the world thanks to Buena Vista Social Club.
Mm-hmm. Esa es la historia.
And for those who don't know, the American musician that Celine was referring to is Ry Cooter. And Ry Cooter went to Cuba actually planning to do a album that was about the mixture of African musicians and Cuban musicians together, and this was almost 20 years ago, and what happened was the African musicians at the last moment did not get their visas to go to Cuba. Ry Cooter was there, and he had the intention of putting them together with some older Cuban musicians, and he began to find some of these people who had somewhat been forgotten a little bit as Cuban music modernized, and that became that music without the African musicians became the Buena Vista Social Club, which was the name of the album, the name of the group. And in fact, the Buena Vista Social Club was a club and similar to what they had, and it existed in Havana. They used this name. It was an old kind of fraternity, and it became the word that they used to describe this kind of music. And as Maraca said, it took this kind of traditional Cuban music and made it, again, a global kind of phenomenon. And we're actually quite lucky. We're going to have the Buena Vista Social Club here later in Aspen in August, August 21st. They're doing just a few dates in the United States, but they are a really global phenomenon. And great description. Did they play before Son? So do we want to make some Son, or are we... Or
sí,
should we?
Solamente
yes.
Mencionar a Alfred Thompson, que
we
también es grupo nuestro, y que
that,
tocó con Buena Vista Social
Club. Our saxophone player, who is here, Alfred Thompson, was part of Buena Vista Social
con
Club
Ibrahim
during
Ferrer,
4 years.
Ago.
He's here in the audience, listening to us.
El sonero y rumbero también, lo que está tranquilo, está.
Is a real sonero and rumbero
mucho,
too. He's quiet now, but he's a heavy player.
Había mucho el breakfast. Quiet. He's quiet now.
¿Tú quieres entonces, tocar algo de eso?
Diría que escucharan el... Igual, si quieren hacer un vivo, pero, no. Pero mejor escucharlo.
¿Pero eso?
Es un, ¿quieren un son o un danzón? ¿Qué quieren?
Lo que tú quieras.
Sí, pero ahí tiene cuerda, o sea...
Por eso. So, Maraca wants you to listen to a danzón, which is another gender which came from the song.
Okay.
A fragment.
Yes. Morceau, so, as you say in French. Morceau, as you say in French.
Morceau.
hay una clave diferente en el danzón.
You can listen to another clave here.
¿Puede tocarlo?
It's still a clave, but it's a different one. But it's a clave.
Eso es un danzón.
So this gender is called danzón.
Pero que en el danzón al cabo es un género del siglo XIX.
It's a gender which was born in the 19th century.
Y un buen día, ya en el siglo XX, a mediados más o menos, se fue alegrando, no sé, se fue complicando más y entonces se hizo esta parte que vieron ahora que se llama cha cha cha.
And then the danzón, in the middle of the 20th century, gave birth to the cha-cha-cha, which is the central part of the danzón. The last one you heard was a kind of cha-cha-cha.
Y las personas querían bailar más.
Because people wanted to dance more, and they enjoyed this part, and it got a separate gender. It became a separate gender, known as cha-cha-cha.
Concluyó en otro género, que se llamó cha-cha-cha. O sea, ya se fue del danzón.
And cha-cha-cha became very popular, as it is. As a cha-cha-cha.
Pero su origen es el danzón, que a la misma vez venía de la contradanza, la danza europea.
Uh-huh. And but it became from danzón and contradanza, son and all these genres.
Y entonces el cha-cha-cha lo conocen, me imagino.
Do you know cha-cha-cha?
No es un son y no es una rumba.
It's not a son, it's not a rumba,
y
it's
no
another gender, powerful gender of Cuban music.
¿Quieren escucharlo?
Do you want to listen to more?
Yes, yes, of course.
Buena noticia, no tiene clave.
The good news is there's no clave in cha-cha-cha. There are several ways to play it. The tumbao, ¿qué cosa es un tumbao? The pattern of the piano. Keeps on changing. This is a pattern of son. This is the pattern of cha-cha-cha, which is very different. And the pattern of the bass is also different.
Thank you.
But it was a kind of big cha-cha-cha dance song.
So we've been listening to a lot of the traditional forms of Cuban music and Cuban rhythms, the son, clave, rumba. But in Cuba today, there is a whole new thing which is happening. And Cuban music today has evolved tremendously and has been influenced by many other kinds of music. So we're going to finish the program with what is happening in Cuba today, how it's interacted with other kinds of music from the United States and other places, and then find out a little bit from Maraca about what's happening in Cuba. And then we'll have a little bit of time at the end for some questions, if anyone has them. So please tell us a little bit about timba. Many people, I'm curious, has anyone here heard of the Cuban form of music called timba? Raise your hand if you've heard of it. Just a few, okay. So there's other things happening now, and more. Is it okay? Did I say something? Yes.
Ya hablamos de la evolución de la música cubana. O sea, la música que vino de España, de África, se fundió. Se convirtió en música cubana.
Talking about the evolution of Cuban music, you know, two centuries ago, okay, we understand that there was a lot of mixture.
Pasaron años y siglos de música cubana.
And centuries have, you know, gone.
Pero el calentamiento global nos ha llevado a unas nuevas evoluciones, más calientes.
But global heat it's important in Cuba too.
O sea, si comparamos los bailes que venían de Europa, que eran las mujeres y los hombres vestidos con una vestimenta increíblemente, bueno, era una obra de arte lo que traían.
So if we compare the yesterday dances, traditional dances, you know, of the 19th century to the dances today,
si pudiéramos
it's a huge difference.
Ver por un momento lo que se está bailando ahora en la música cubana actual.
So if you could see now what people and young people dance in Cuba, you would get very
pero
impressed.
Pienso que sigue siendo igual, o sea, muy alegre, muy contagioso.
The general feeling is that people are always, you know, willing to dance, and there's a lot of dance and happiness in Cuba.
Pero todo ha cambiado, o sea, los conceptos, las fusiones.
But of course, it kept on evolving.
No estamos de espalda al mundo, o sea, nosotros sabemos perfectamente el hip hop. Rap,
and many influences are brought to Cuban music, such as hip hop and rap.
En Cuba hay de todos. Hay grupos de rock, grupos hasta la música árabe, India,
todo.
And in
Cuba, you can find many different music, rock, pop, you know, all the time, not only traditional.
Y la timba, que es uno de esos géneros modernos, aunque bueno, ahora han surgido otros aún más modernos.
And the so-called timba is a kind of modern, you know, mixture.
Que nosotros pudiéramos mostrar un poquito, pero bueno, no tanto, porque tendríamos que depender de una orquestación.
It's hard to show what timba can sound, because it usually supports large format, mm-hmm. You know,
pero
large
bueno,
bands.
Los tumbados, o sea, que son los patrones de piano. De
but you can, we can, for example, listen to some timba patterns on the piano, which are very
son
different.
Un poco distintos.
Different from the son montunos one or cha cha cha.
Ya cambia, pero siguen siendo cubanos y siguen siendo contagiosos. Si quieren podemos escuchar un elemento de timba o hacerlo también. También porque el tumbado de piano, por ejemplo.
For example, the Cuban the piano pattern. Still the clave.
Same clave,
different pattern.
You want to play?
Yeah.
Hold on. So Maraca is going to call up from his zero.
This is the full version.
So you can hear the roots, the traditional roots, but this is a very evolved form of modern music. It has the rhythm, but it's more modern, it's more aggressive in a certain way, and it's very popular dance music for younger people today.
Sí, los jóvenes están buscando también música electrónica también.
In Cuba, young people also are looking for electronic music and are more into more modern technologies, integrating more modern technologies to their music also, DJs.
Pero también música acústica, hay una revolución musical, se está fusionando todos, estamos ahora en un momento que estamos recreando.
Now there's a big we are in a big creative moment in Cuba, in the music.
Lo más importante y más difícil es conservar lo que ya nosotros tenemos, que es la herencia musical anterior.
And the kind of danger of this is also because it's so open to other influences that, you know, they might forget where they're coming from.
Muchos jóvenes, antes de conocer su raíz, su cultura, empiezan a imitar un poco, en principio, ¿no? La música que viene de afuera, que sobre todo la que más entra, la más potente, la americana.
The general tendency of the young people, young musicians, is picking up a lot of American music and bring them to their music, but sometimes they just don't know Cuban music
at all. And
that's why educating, you know, and educating people and young musicians and young people is important.
Porque además el día que ellos, por ejemplo, estén en el Festival de Aspect, por un ejemplo, poner un ejemplo, y van a tocar con un grupo de reggaetón o de rap americano, ellos no pueden tocar desde Cuba la misma música. Tienen que tocar la música.
And definitely their music is still the Cuban music. It's, you know, their first feeling and their first heritage is Cuban music.
Y es lo que nos ha permitido llegar hasta aquí. O sea, todo lo que han hecho los maestros de la música cubana desde que empezó hasta ahora.
And the great masters in Cuban music should never be forgotten because they had Cuban music very popular and very respected all over the world.
De esa manera no me cabe duda que la música cubana tiene un gran futuro y va a seguir influenciando a todo el mundo. Aunque el embargo dure 500 años más.
But I'm sure that in spite of the embargo, it can last 500 years. I'm sure that Cuban music is going to be influential
Pero
all the time.
Ojalá y quiten,
as it's been.
Ojalá y lo quiten y verán que vamos a tener mucho más comunicación.
But
más
we would like the embargo to cease, you know, in order to
nosotros también
keep
necesitamos
on
en Cuba
with
más
American music.
Cultura americana para poder entender más.
And also, sea. You know, more exchanges in Cuba so that Cuban musicians and people can, you know, see bands live and, in Cuba.
Right. So most of the, what's interesting that they're talking about for me is that all the modern music which is happening here in America is very influential right now in Cuba despite the embargo, despite this relationship, despite the fact that music isn't easily imported, but it's there. It's been getting there no matter what. It's something that cannot be stopped by borders or electronics or anything. And it's interesting to hear how in Cuba today, young musicians, young people, probably not all that different from young musicians and people in the United States, very driven by what has become a global kind of sound, the absence of borders, rock music, pop music, electronic, what's called electronica, DJ, all of these things which are patterns that have become very popular and driving are happening in Cuba. And you can hear the beginnings of this influence and is that, As they're saying in Cuba, of course, people do love to dance, and the young people today. Well, so if what are people dancing? The young people now, what are they dancing to? When if they're in the battle, what are they listening? What are they listening to, and what are they dancing to?
Los jóvenes están monotemáticos, o sea, solamente escuchan, bailan reggaetón.
There's one very, very, very popular gender, and almost the only one is reggaeton.
Entonces los viejos. Los más viejos dicen que se está acabando la música cubana.
So, you know, the older generation say, well, Cuban music is over.
Pero que según los libros de de la historia de la música cubana, eso existió desde un principio. ¿Sí?
But that's the same old story from the beginning. You know?
Entonces, el reggaetón, que es el último género, tiene el ritmo de la habanera, que es un género hiper antiguo.
And we can find that in reggaeton, you know, this so popular genre has some common elements of la habanera, which is an ancient, very ancient genre.
Cuando surgieron esos instrumentos en la música cubana, el timbal, que venía del tímpano y no había timbal en la música nuestra, y las congas, cuando eso surgió en la música popular cubana, hay escritos de la época que dicen que llegó la muerte de la música cubana.
And one century and a half ago, when the timbales, which come from the timpani, you know, the classical timpani, when the timbales started to be used in Cuban music as well as the conga, some critics and journalists and people used to say that it was the end of Cuban music because
también
it was
escrito,
too loud.
Han escrito que bailar
it was
con,
one century and a half ago.
Bailar con traje de baño, o sea, de playa, las mujeres en el escenario es una falta de respeto, que no sé qué.
And then, yeah, you know, you have this woman dancing in a very bikini.
Pero es la evolución. Y entonces, ya ahora la gente baila en el escenario con trajes increíbles, o sea, impresionante.
So it's a natural evolution, we think.
Y pienso que lo que están escuchando los jóvenes, lo más importante, no es lo que escuchan, sino que entiendan que para crear hay que estudiar lo uno, ¿no? El ADN nuestro, que es la clave.
But the most important thing is that young people should never forget, you know, and should in a certain way be aware of their roots, you know, musical.
Y aquí está el ejemplo de lo que estoy hablando, o sea, son muy jóvenes.
And we have very young musician in the band, for example, 22 years old.
Y tiene 20 y Yomel tiene por ahí 23. Y entonces ellos ya conocen danzón, son rumba, todo.
We are very young players in the band, and it's a good signal that it's possible.
Es posible hacer DJ y toda esa cosa, pero con conociendo.
It's possible to be a DJ and to be a young, you know, young person listening to reggaeton and dancing,
futuro,
but also appreciating others.
En un futuro no muy lejano podrá hablarse de algunos géneros o de alguna música cubano-americana. O sea, que va a haber tanta fusión entre la música cubana y la americana, por supuesto, después que se abra el candado ese del embargo, que vamos a ser locales, o sea, vamos a bailar posiblemente igual aquí como si estuviéramos en La Habana.
It's true that Cuban and American music have always been closed, you know, mm-hmm. and we hope that with these exchanges with Cuba, music will be better.
La música cubana hay que definir. Es un virus que se ha expandido por todo el mundo.
Cuban music is like a virus.
Y no tiene marcha atrás.
It's everywhere in any gender.
No tiene cura.
It's a good virus.
Yeah, good virus.
So,
and there's no treatment.
Huh?
There's no treatment.
It's not, yeah, no treatment. No, it's incurable. That's true. We saw that last night. So we have a little bit of time for some, a couple of questions, and then we're going to finish up. We're going to let the band, after a couple of questions, we're going to let them send you out with one musical selection of their choice. So, yes.
I was having a question about the training of musicians in Cuba. I think I understand that there has been classical conservatories, like there. I know that another group, Tiempari Libre, was trained classically at a Russian conservatory in Havana. Are these musicians, did you start classical and then become, go to the style? Yes? So I'm curious about that. Like, when did you start? What's the typical pattern?
Ella está curiosa, cómo empezaron, cómo estudiaron, qué estudiaron, si estudiaron conservatorio.
Gracias por la pregunta.
Thank you for your question.
Todos somos graduados, estudiados de distintos niveles.
All the musicians are graduated from the conservatory and high school of music.
Y lo sabíamos, pero ahora cada día comprobamos más al viajar por el mundo que la enseñanza artística y musical en Cuba es increíble. O sea, somos una potencia en eso.
Musical education in Cuba is very high level. And we've been traveling all over the world, and each time we notice that it's a very high level.
Por supuesto, todo no puede ser música. O sea, para los que cultivamos los géneros populares también, todo no puede ser clásico, todo no puede ser en la escuela.
So it's mainly classical training they got in music schools, no popular music.
Hay que tener un poco de calle, de vivir. Es como el jazz que era una música muy popular, como la rumba, como... Entonces se convirtió en algo elitista.
So, you know, it's like jazz. Jazz at the beginning was popular music and it was not taught in conservatory. Well, that's the same in Cuba. Popular music is not taught in music school.
Y nosotros estamos todavía en la época como Cat Calloway y en la época del swing que la gente se ponía unos trajes de brillo.
In Cuba they're still in the, you know, this period the of Cap Calloway and the
es como
the swing
la, como
area.
La música cubana actual, la salsa, la timba, es como Cap Calloway, entonces ale, 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 la gente.
It's very popular and interactive with audiences.
O sea, que no hemos
like
perdido,
to dress, like to interact with people.
No hemos perdido contacto directo y cercano
so
al público.
Cuban music is still remains popular and danceable, you know. It didn't lose its this element.
Pero
like
ya
in
no
jazz,
somos
jazz became quite, you know, intellectual music now,
yes.
Mostly.
La
not
diferencia,
for dancing, not
la diferencia
public.
Es que ya no somos empíricos, ahora estamos bien estudiados.
But the difference is that many of the musicians who played Cuban popular music are from the music school.
Y una prueba de todo esto que hemos hablado está en este disco.
For example, one of the proof of what we say,
Reencuentros.
It's included in this new CD, DVD.
Y tiene muchos géneros, muchas fusiones,
which
mucha
has
historia.
Many genders, many stories, interesting stories.
Así que los estoy invitando a que lo escuchen para que cuando nosotros nos vayamos no se pierda lo que hemos hablado.
And I invited you to listen to that CD and see the DVD, which is a live recording at the Grand Opera, the Great Theater of Havana.
Thank you.
With the Havana Chamber Orchestra.
Okay, we have time for one more question and then one.
No,
yes.
Yeah.
Hola, estoy tan feliz de verlos aquí y tengo una pregunta, bueno, un comentario, una pregunta y después lo puedo decir en inglés. Yo lamento muchísimo que la música cubana no penetró en los Estados Unidos como en otras partes del mundo, porque gente de mi generación en los 20 y los 30 no conocen la música cubana. Y como conocemos otros estilos de puertorriqueño, dominicana, y por eso yo pienso creció la música reggaetón en este país mucho. Yo quiero saber cómo ven ustedes que van a cambiar las cosas entre este tipo de música viniendo más a Miami, a Nueva York, a otras partes de los Estados Unidos, para que la juventud sí puede definitivamente conocer la música cubana y el nivel, es la música mejor del mundo. Entonces, para nosotros no tenerlo fue un crimen. Y yo quiero saber cómo va a cambiar las cosas en el futuro.
Can you translate
sure.
into English shortly?
So, basically I said that it's a crime that people in their 20s and 30s, such as myself in the United States, did not get to learn about Cuban music, did not know about Cuban music. I think it contributed also to why styles like reggaeton became so popular. So I want to know, you know, it's like a lost generation of young people that will not know Los Bamban, Cándido Fabre. And so I would like to know how that's changing very specifically yes. in places like Miami, New York. How is Cuban music going to be introduced more?
Sí, un español.
We go on in Spanish.
Gracias por tu pregunta, que es muy buena.
Thanks for your question.
Es el precio que estamos pagando todos, tanto ustedes como nosotros, por la incomunicación de que habló Jim al principio. O sea, el embargo americano. O sea, que no nos impidió crecer, pero sí impidió que llegáramos y que nos pudiéramos vender aquí.
Yes, basically the embargo on Cuba didn't... Can you translate?
You have a microphone?
Well,
con la
you
voz.
Can go, just
you can go. So it's very sad that the embargo in Cuba did not allow for this kind of knowledge of the music in those days.
Entonces, bueno, la solución más inmediata la tuvieron un grupo pequeño de americanos. Viajaron a algunos lugares donde había cubanos, o sea, en México, en Europa. Bailaba, yo decía, bueno, ¿por qué bailan tan rico los americanos? ¿Por qué se divierten tanto? Porque tenían una sed de música cubana, porque no la tienen aquí, como bien tú dijiste.
So there was a small group of Americans that would go to other parts of the world, Mexico and the Caribbean, and were starting to listen to this kind of music.
Pero muy sencillo, la solución es, la, a mi opinión modesta, es la siguiente, o sea, si permiten a los americanos, mm-hmm. norteamericanos, no cubanos, norteamericanos. No cubanos porque ya los cubanos están autorizados a viajar libremente mm-hmm. a Cuba, como a todos los países del mundo.
Yeah.
Como a China, que es un país de un sistema parecido o muy, muy parecido al nuestro. ¿No? Y sin embargo, los americanos pueden hacer lo que quieran en China y no pueden hacerlo en Cuba, que está al lado. Eso es absolutamente absurdo.
So, one of the answers is to allow Americans to travel freely to Cuba. like is happening in China. The fact that it can happen in China and not in Cuba is absurd, in my opinion.
Y entonces, bueno, cuando abran esa puerta imaginaria que está bien cerrada, podrán conocer la persona. Quizás ya ustedes van a ser víctimas, no van a tener que con una tardanza conocer la música que no conocen, valga la redundancia, porque no les llegó. Pero los más jóvenes, que son los del futuro, mm-hmm. van a conocernos a nosotros y nosotros a ellos.
So hopefully in the future, younger people, when those doors become open, will be able to understand our music and us their music.
Así que hay una solución inmediata, muy sencilla. No soy político, soy músico, claro, pero la solución es Obama, que es que tiene la llave.
So the solution is Obama, not a politician.
Así que,
but
a pocas palabras, todo está dicho.
In few words, that's
Thank you very
all
much.
Is said.
Okay. So our session is finished, but we're going to leave you how we started with one more so, which is a snippet of Cuban music that the band would like to leave you with to send you out. We'd like to thank you all very much for coming, and please spread the word of this magnificent culture and this magnificent music. Tell your friends, help them, listen. They'll be moved, and it's a wonderful cultural project. No, unfortunately, last night was their show, and they played two nights, one night in Glenwood to open the free jazz series, and then last night they were part of the Jazz Aspen
next
performance.
Next show in Milwaukee.
Milwaukee is available, however, if you'd like
Milwaukee,
to.
Milwaukee, Minneapolis, Chicago, wherever, but
they're on tour. They're on tour, but
New York, Washington.
Good, but they'll be back to Aspen, I promise you. We have long friendship, and they'll be back here. I'm not sure when, I hope next year, but many times, we hope.
In New York? 19th of July, SOBs. Washington, D.C., Kennedy Center, 25th.
Oh, nice. Where are you playing in New York?
SOBs.
July 19th at SOBs,
yeah,
which is the first club of world music in the United States, in Soho, Houston, and 6th Avenue. Great club. If you're in New York, July 19th.
Chicago, July 10th. For the Folk and Roots Festival, July 10, Wells Park.
Okay, one more song for the road.
Bueno, vamos a tocar la música que no llegó aquí.
We're going to play the music which didn't come to the U.S.
De un gigante de la música cubana, un genio de la música cubana que se llama Benny Moré.
A giant of Cuban music called Benny Moré.
Antes de despedirme, quiero darle las gracias a Jim, al festival,
and
a
I would like
ustedes.
To thank you all, thank Jim, thank everybody.
Invitarlos a todos los que quieran bailar, tocar aquí. Yo sé
and
que
please
miedo
feel
y pena.
Free to dance if you want.
Tienen miedo y pena, pero nosotros no mordemos.
Don't be scared.
Y entonces tú, por ejemplo, que tienes origen latino, porque habla como los puertorriqueños o algo así. Ve, si es posible, por favor, ven y toca lo que quieras, una clave, una maraca. O baila
and feel free to grab a clave dale. Or something and try to.
Everybody, stand up. Vamos, stand up. Boom, boom. Oye, ¿cómo dice? Thompson, Andy, Yomel, Valiente, José Miguel y Maraga. Thank you very much.